What's your crunch, Army? Where you at? Your motivation guy is back. It's no secret that getting good at Fortnite on controller is not an easy process. And that's why in today's videos, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be going over 15 of the best tips for you controller players out there. Where are my controller players at? Hey, I see you. We're going to speed through these tips, guys, so that you can gain as much as possible from this video and get a ton of tips, man, that are going to help you, you know, when it comes to improving and reaching the highest level as a controller player. Alright, so speaking of improving at Fortnite, be sure to check out ProGuides.com, where you can find a pro coach like right now. Yeah, I said right now. This second, head on over to ProGuides.com, where you can find pro players to help you analyze your gameplay and help you spot mistakes. Or you can do a live session to work on your game sense, mechanics, strategy, or anything else. Bunch of Crunch Army, it's about that time. Here we go. It's time to sit back, relax, and grab some of my favorite candy. What is that, y'all? It's that Bunch of Crunch. Yeah. And let's get this going. When it comes to finding your dead zones on controller, start by setting it to 15% on each axis. Then slowly bring it down until you start to feel stick drift. Basically, your controller moving on its own or, you know, moving more than it's supposed to. Set your dead zones to, you know, 1-3% above that point, and then you're gonna have the perfect dead zones. Basically, you're gonna be low enough where your controller is super responsive, but high enough where it's not too responsive and doesn't move on its own. On controller, man, try to implement a more smooth play style instead of just being fast and flicky. With controller sticks, it's simply so much more consistent to move slower and be more precise about your movements. On joysticks, it's just so much harder to be fast and flicky, which is why when you watch pretty much any controller pro, you're gonna notice their mechanics look more smooth as opposed to fast, and they tend to move their crosshair a bit slower in favor of precision. So try to implement that into your own gameplay and just really see how it goes. Okay guys, so another huge tip for controller players is you've got to ADS when you're taking your shot. It reduces your sensitivity, allowing you to be more precise, you know, reduces your bullet spread, and makes it easier to hit your target directly. So if you haven't already, guys, try and build that habit. When it comes to being as good as possible on controller, try and consider ordering some controller paddles, like a scuff controller or a strike pack, which you can just simply attach to your controller, or using the claw grip, which allows you to do so many more actions at one time. Both of these will help you improve your mechanics to a whole nother level and will seriously make a huge difference if you practice enough. Since controller quite obviously has aim assist, okay, one of the best methods to practice your aim on controller is by doing some aim duels against another player. Since you're up against an actual person, your aim assist will work so you're able to practice the mechanics of that, you know, along with your general click timing or tracking aim. To do some aim duels, we recommend checking out Raiders 464's aim duel map. All right, 8595-7789-7339, which you can customize a ton and just use one of many different maps and many different weapons. So be sure to check that out as soon as possible. All right, guys, so double edit binds. On controller, we strongly recommend setting up double edit binds so you can just edit as fast as possible. So a few good combinations are pressing your left and right joysticks, a joystick and L2, or even another button if you play claw, or a paddle if you have them. You can set up double binds by simply just setting one edit bind on your building and combat sections and setting the other bind for your editing section in your bind settings. Alright guys, so another huge tip for a controller player, since you can't be quite as precise, alright, is to practice your awkward edits in creative. Awkward edits are basically edits from weird angles, like editing from a box away or when you're stuck up against a wall. So practicing awkward edits as opposed to your usual edit courses and free building will help you dramatically when trying to improve your editing on controller. When it comes to linear versus exponential input curves, all right, we strongly recommend choosing linear out of the two. Linear, guys, all right, let's break it down. It basically makes you just more precise, as the further away your joystick is from the center, it'll get faster in a linear pattern instead of just being away too fast at the end and way too slow near the middle. However, okay, if you want to be a little bit more flicky and mechanical and simply just prefer it, then you can still be really good on exponential. However, the general agreement among controller players is that linear is just better for most players. And speaking of mechanics, don't forget that you can always ask one of our pro coaches on ProGuides.com to either review your gameplay or coach you one-on-one in-game, you know, if you're struggling to improve your mechanics. Because I'm gonna tell you this, oftentimes it's caused by something you just don't realize. And our pro coaches can really help you spot that exact issue and solve it, okay? Aiming on controller is obviously way different than mouse and keyboard. On mouse and keyboard, I mean, you could usually get away with just trying to flick or look flashy, but on controller, especially if you play on linear like we recommend, precision is gonna be critical in close range. That's where trigger discipline really, really comes in. Like, what I want you guys to start doing whenever you're in a box with someone is take a few extra milliseconds to just line up your shot on your opponent's head instead of just firing the instant you see them. This extra bit of time, you know, to line up your shot can easily turn a 30 damage shot into a 200 one. So keep your trigger discipline, okay? And just don't, you know, opt to take a shot when you know it's not optimal. So finding your perfect sensitivity on controller, it's gonna save you a lot of hassle really in the long run. So starting early and finding it now is the best idea. So what we recommend doing is starting your sensitivity at 40% X and Y and simply just adjusting up or down depending on what you like. Spend a bit doing this, adjusting it up and down as you feel fit, and you should be able to just define a good sensitivity nice and super quick, all right? So the same thing goes for your ADS sensitivity, which we recommend starting at 12% X and Y, and your building and editing sensitivities, which you should both start at 2.0X. Another tip that's really gonna help you guys tremendously in box fights is to start using cones instead of ramps. Okay, so if you place a cone in an opponent's box in sort of a mongrel classic, you know, kind of way, they're gonna be super exposed and they're gonna be able to just simply peek and just clean up the kill that way. This is a super easy and really effective way to get kills quickly, and that mixed with other close range tips that we've discussed in this video, along with the good old aim assist, woo, it's gonna make for a deadly combo. So on controller in Fortnite, playing from a distance and close range fights as well is gonna help you guys a lot. Like if you're up close and personal, you're gonna have to make much more mechanical plays, right? And that's often a weak point of controller players. All of that fancy edit plays that keyboard and mouse players like to pull off. On controller, playing from a slight distance in fights, often like a box away or something like that, like that's gonna prove to be super helpful. Okay, speaking of playing from distance in fights, one of the best ways to do that and still get damage and win the fight is by using piece control. So basically, piece control just refers to building pieces around your opponent so they're unable to escape. A few common piece control techniques include this. All right, placing cones in your opponent's box, like we discussed earlier, building a floor and cone above an opponent who's building up, and then editing through for a shot. Editing, then placing walls around your opponent to block them from escaping the side. Those are just a few examples of piece control techniques, but there are many more that you can just learn and really start using to maintain distance in fights and really outplay your opponents. All right, guys, so controller gameplay is quite obviously very specific to controller, which is why we strongly recommend learning directly from controller pros. So top tier controller players like Unknown, you know, Lechi, CRR, just to name a few. You know, so these guys, you know, they're really good names that you should be watching and learning, you know, to really, really step up your game on controller. And as usual, you can feel free to ask one of our controller coaches, man, at proguys.com, who can help give you tailored advice and tips as well. But if you prefer doing it on your own, yo, hey, do your thing. You know, watching pro player streams and videos and just learning from their gameplay is also solid, all right? And finally, for our last tip, we've got consistent practice. So on controller, you have to be much more precise, and it's easy to get rusty after only a day or two off, right? And that's why we recommend trying to play as often as possible, even if your sessions aren't very long. So a 30-minute session every day is much better than, you know, 2-hour sessions per week. Practicing on a consistent basis on controller is gonna allow you to avoid losing your skill and really just keep you on track with your improvement. All right, overall guys, from settings to piece control to the best ways to practice, this video covers 15 of the most important tips you guys should know when playing on controller. So we tried to compile some of the best tips of all time. So whether you're brand new to controller or, you know, pretty experienced, right? Hopefully you gain quite a bit from this video. All right, guys, once again, it's your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. So if you guys enjoyed this video, you want to see more of the best tips and tricks content on YouTube, be sure to drop a like and sub to the channel. And once again, be sure to check out proguys.com so you can find your coach. Also, feel free to check out our Pro Guys community Discord, man. It is really cool. We got some great people. We got a big family, right? It's down in the description if you want a nice place to just hang out, all right? And really, you can also find teammates and enter into giveaways. And bunch of crunch, army. Keep eating that bunch of crunch, and let's get this going.